What has your experience been like in terms of, I know we touched on this earlier, but dealing with the intellectual property office, you guys didn't do any, you guys don't have any patents out as yet, because you'll need to do, I guess, more detailed designs, not just grouping consumer products, but by making like a purpose-built product specifically for your, well, your application.
Yes, that is
And only
is
then you could apply for the patent.
Yes, so even if, I mean, if you have a design and you can demonstrate how it would work, that then you can go ahead and patent it. You see, patenting takes time, right? And it also costs money. So you, if it is that we go ahead and we try to patent something that at this point isn't patentable, or is a slim chance that it might actually be defendable, and wasting money.
Right. Right. How expensive is getting a patent down here?
So the cost is really the lawyer fees, and the fact that we don't have a lot of lawyers who could help with the patent process. I don't know the specific filing cost. I'll have to do a little more research on that.
Yeah, because I get a feeling like we don't file a lot of patents in this country.
No. I mean, there are a few people who do it, but it, there's much more to do to patenting than just filing the patent. You have to file a patent that you know people will want to buy the product from you, right? Based upon, now there are a lot of persons doing research in the field that I'm doing. So it's not just as simple as, okay, well, I created something, so people, I need to patent it. I need to be able to know, okay, what is the demand specifically for this once it's patented, right? And I have an idea, but we need to promote it. So what, once you promote it and we know that people are willing to buy it, then we can say, okay, here's what. You need to make sure that this is protected fully.
I think that's a kind of bad approach, though. Well, not on your part. I just think as a country, we should be, if we want to promote innovation in this country, we should be making patenting as easy and as cheap as possible, maybe even free. I think patenting should just be funded by the government or something, because if you look at a lot of patents that are done in the US and different countries, the patents aren't done because they're economically viable. A lot of the time, they're just done to protect your idea, to make sure that nobody else can come in and monetize it. You even have a lot of incomplete ideas that are patented. I know Apple patented the shape of the iPad. It's like they patented an actual shape. You have more ridiculous patents. I'm sure I could probably get some examples. But
yeah, well, they would have protected the industrial design for it.
Yeah.
So there's a little bit of difference between patenting and industrial design protection. So if I do a design of a particular shape, I can protect that. But patenting is a lot more involved, right? So, and your protection is for basically 20 years. So you can patent the technology, you can patent a process, but you can't really patent the shape. You can protect the shape.
Right, through industrial design, like not really trademark, but as in your, it'll still be your intellectual property for a particular shape.
Yeah, kind of like how the chubby bottle is patented.
I think it's just bad to have something like lawyer fees as a potential barrier between, you know, you and getting your idea patented. And is our patent, or is something patented by our IPO recognized worldwide or just in certain regions?
No, so if you patent something in Trinidad, it's only protected in Trinidad. And similarly, if you patent something in the US, it's only protected in the US. So that's the trick with patenting.
Yeah.
You have to protect, you have to file the patent in the different countries that you intend to trade in.
But I think, this is not something I have a lot of experience in, so I'll probably have to look it up further. But I think the US Patent Office also has like partnerships with like the whatever patent office the Europeans use, you know, so that they don't infringe on each other's patents. So like if you patent in one country, it might be automatically recognized in another. But I know Asia is completely different because they just kind of, I don't think they care much about intellectual property at all.
Yeah. So, I mean, in Asia, you know, it might even be frowned upon for them because they innovate through copying different things, right?
Yeah.
And then they improve it and then they can patent it. In the US, you okay, so there are different companies that could help you with filing patents. And so if it is you, let's say you go online, you say you want a patent in these countries, you can automatically have it patented in Australia, in the US, in England, wherever, right? But if it is you're filing directly with a particular patent agency, then you're only part protected in that one country. So you can utilize the service to patent in multiple countries.